Good morning, children. Welcome to social class. This is A. Manoj Kumar, working in Oxford High School, Uppugunduru. We have been discussing about the polar regions. So, up to now, I explained you introduction part of polar regions. What is tundra? Okay, na? Where tundra region located? Everything we discussed. Regarding the season, little bit information I given in the last class. Especially last class we discussed about seasons. Now I am going to explain about summer season in tundra region. We have different seasons like summer, winter, rainy. Summer, winter, autumn, spring. Like that, we have different seasons. In tundra, the continent is Arctic continent, if you see, that is entirely different from other continents. Isn't it or not? Summer. The sun begins to shine February and March. That means slowly sunrises are falling in that area in the month of February and March. Okay, that to be sunrises not directly falling, slantly sunrises are falling. You know, that is far away located from the equator region. Which one? Polar regions located far away from the equatorial regions. Far away from the sun, these regions are. So that sunrises are falling slantly. Okay, so this February and March month, these both important because the sun shines from these months, February and March. Then in the beginning, sun shines maximum of an hour or 1.5 hour. Then afterwards, it sets. Okay, now in the beginning of February and March, especially in the February month, only sun appears 1 hour or else 1.5 hour in the initial period. Afterwards, gradually, then shining of the sun lengthens. That means what, sir? So gradually it lengthens. That means shining of sun 2 hours, 8 hours, 16 hours and finally 24 hours it shines. Which shines? Sun shines 24 hours afterwards. Initial period only 1 hour sun appears. Afterwards 2 hours it appears. Then gradually 8 hours it appears. 16 hours it appears. Then 24 hours it appears. If you compare it with our location, our area, we have 12 hours day, 12 hours night, total 24 hours. But here entirely different. When sun shines February and March, initially it appears only 1 hour, afterwards 2 hours, 4 hours, 8 hours, 16 hours, 24 hours. Like that it appears. Which appears? Sun appears. Okay, if you see in the months of May, June, July. For us, May, June, July, those are especially May, summer period. June onwards, rains will start in our area. We are talking about tundra region. May, June, July. These 3 months, the sun never sets. Very, very important. Sun never sets in tundra region. 24 hours sun appears. The sun does not rise overhead. Another important point is, in our areas, by 12 o'clock, sun is our overhead. That is called midday. Okay, na? We are saying good afternoon. When onwards we will say 12. Isn't it or not? But here in tundra region, the sun does not rise overhead. Very, very important. Even though May, June, July, sun never sets, but point is, sun does not rise overhead. Okay, na? It is far away from the, this location is, tundra location is far away from the sun. Okay, it just hovers a little above the horizon. Okay, now very, very important. It just hovers a little above the horizon. Here, one point we have to understand, what is horizon, sir? Sometimes, if you are seeing far away place, what we may observe, so the sky touches the earth. Okay, such a incidence we are seeing. That is called horizon. See, where the earth appears to meet the sky, that is called horizon. Okay, now do you understand what is origin? Where the earth appears to meet the sky. Where the sky appears to, sorry, where the earth appears to meet the sky, that is called horizon. Once again, I will say, where the earth appears to touch the sky, where the earth appears to meet the sky or touch the sky, that is called horizon. Do you understand what is horizon? Okay. Since the sun does not go high up in the sky, it is never very warm. Isn't it, Anna? Tell me. If one particular region, one particular area receives directly sun rays, then temperatures are heavy. Warm conditions prevail. Even though these 3 months, especially May, June, July, these 3 months, sun never sets, but temperatures are very low. This place is far away from the sun. The reason is, this place is, particular place is far away from the sun. Do you understand? Even in the 3 months of summer, it is, okay na, even though it is cold, but it is comparatively less cold. Okay na, comparatively less cold. Do you understand? Even in the 3 months of summer, It is cold, but it is not comparatively less cold. Why, sir? In summer, what is cold, sir? In our area, we have high temperatures are registering, na? Why you are mentioning cold in summer? But this area receives sun rays very, very slantly. Okay, na? So that temperatures are low, cold conditions prevailed even in the summer. But comparatively in winter, summer, okay, na, temperatures are okay, little bit high, not very high, little bit high, but compare, okay, na, but here cold conditions prevailed from Jan to December. Do you understand? Then, due to the relatively warm weather, warm conditions, okay, little warm conditions prevailed in this area in the months of May, June, July. Weather summer was just due to that region, then ice melts. Due to the relative warm conditions, slowly ice melts in that particular area. That area receives which are frozen during the winter and began to flow. Okay, now then here I will give the clarity. Due to the melting of the ice, then slowly that ice, okay, now so make as a water, turn as a water and flows down areas. Do you understand? So the rivers which are frozen up to the May, slowly that river water turn as water. Do you understand? The rivers which are frozen during the winter melt and began to flow. The lakes fill up and huge chunks of ice break off and float in the ocean as icebergs. We are observing the icebergs now and then. In the National Geographic channel, they are showing icebergs. These icebergs are huge chunks of ice separating from the, okay na, that means already before May, the total river area, frozen conditions, afterwards it break off. Then huge chunks of ice flow on the water. Okay, then we called as these huge chunks of water icebergs. Do you understand? So the land which was frozen during the winter comes alive with color during summer. Okay, in winter total conditions are different. Where? In tundra region. There is no possibility to grow any kind of crops, any kind of trees in tundra region. Slowly, what happens, you know, in summer, ice is melting, then some vegetation we will observe in tundra region. During the winter, comes alive with color during the summer. Some colorful flowers we may observe summer season in tundra region. Do you understand? Then, when summer approaches, many multicolored plants like leeches, grass, shrubs, and berries sprout all around. They bear fruits and flowers. Okay, different, these ओके ट्रीज हैविंग डिफरेंट कलर्स डिफरेंट फ्लावर्स दे बेर डिफरेंट फ्रूट्स एंड डिफरेंट फ्लावर्स डू यू अंडरस्टैंड देन मेनी एनिमल्स ऑलरेडी इन द विंटर सीजन मेनी एनिमल्स माइग्रेटेड इस वेन अवर समर अप्रोचेस समर कम्स इन टंड्रा रीजन दीज एनिमल्स कमिंग बैक टू दैट रीजन फॉर एग्जाम्पल फेलिकन बर्ड्स आई टोल्ड दिस इज ऑल अबाउट समर इन टंड्रा रीजन डू यू अंडरस्टैंड ओके ना सो वेन समर स्टार्ट मे जून जुलाई इन दीज मंथ एस्पेशली इन द फिब्रवरी मार्च मंथ सन ओके स्टार्ट शाइनिंग आफ्टरवर्ड्स मे जून जुलाई कंप्लीटली सन नेवर सेट्स आफ्टरवर्ड्स स्नो आल्सो स्लोली मेल्टिंग अप दैट फ्रोजन एरिया स्लोली मेल्टिंग अप आइसबर्ग्स आल्सो फ्लोटिंग ऑन द रिवर आर सीज ओके देन that area covered okay covered with some plants like leeches berries these trees okay bear the fruits and flowers then some birds also coming back to this area in the summer season do you understand this is all about summer in tundra region vegetation in the tundra region already we discussed the tundra area totally covered with ice here One definition is very important our examination point of view that is permafrost what is permafrost due to the cold the upper soil surface of the region is frozen into a rock like state all through the year this is called permafrost once again very 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 important due to the cold the upper air surface of the tundra region is frozen into a rock like state that is called permafrost okay na once again due to the cold the upper soil surface of the region is frozen into a rock like state all through the year this is called permafrost okay suppose in our area we are observing hard soils plains plateaus these are all hard soils soft soils isn't it arnas plains are contains hard soils plains soft soils it contains if you hit the deck of the plateaus it is too hard to dig the okay hole through your hand in plateau region because it is covered with rocks okay if you go tundra region same like rock ice covered with that region so that if you hit it hard it not easily break up that ice not easily breaks do you understand so that is permafrost as there is a little soil only some plants grow in that particular area only little soil okay we are observing in that particular area The underground soil being hard, it is difficult for trees to grow. That means the tree roots not possible to grow deep inside of the soil. Okay, total area covered with snow, little soil okay, covers some areas. Even if they do manage to grow, suppose a tree do manage to grow in a particular area, the trees get damaged and uprooted with strong winds and storms. Always cold winds storms blowing hitting that area if you go any desert area Sahara desert Kalahari desert hot winds are blowing continuously hot winds are blowing likewise if you go arctic region tundra region cold winds are blowing heavily cold storms also hitting that particular place so that even though some trees manage to grow due to that cold winds cold storm due to that cold winds and storms the roots of the plant uprooted it damaged the plants which damages winds and storms damages the plants okay most of the tundra region is treeless due to that region most of the tundra region is treeless in this session what we discussed about summer season which is start February and March sun shines in the February month. Okay, May, June, July, continuously sun shines. There is no sunset in that particular region. Afterwards, slowly ice melting, icebergs are floating on the river. Then small plants grow in that particular region. Afterwards, vegetation, regarding the vegetation also we discussed. What is permafrost we discussed? Due to the hard surface, it is not possible to grow. Hard surface means that surface covered with ice, that is permafrost. Okay, so it is not possible to grow any tree. Even though a tree manages to grow, then winds, cold winds and storms, okay, then it damages the trees. All those things we discussed. Okay, na? Thank you. Thank you very much.